إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الكلام كلام الله وأحسن الحدي حدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. وبعد، إخوان، returning back to South Bank Uni after many years, إخوان, of lecturing here. It is no doubt always a pleasure to meet, to travel to meet our brothers wherever they may be, whether they be Ikhwan in various parts of our own city, Birmingham, whether they be in the north of the country, whether they be in various Western countries and many of the countries that we visited, whether Western or otherwise, or whether they have the ill fortune of being lumped here in London, then no doubt, alhamdulillah, I'm only joking, you don't have to screw your face. Don't screw with me. No doubt, Ikhwan, it is always a pleasure to meet with Ikhwan, brothers who we love for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and brothers, Ikhwan, who we come together with because of that which we are upon and that which we share by way of i'tiqad and by way of belief and by way of aqeedah and by way, Ikhwan, of the virtue of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon us from us having the belief in the tawheed of Allah azza wa jal. For indeed, Ikhwan, many are those who have not had the blessing of al-Islam, of al-tawheed, of al-Iman, and thus, Ikhwan, da'iman wa abadan, constantly, it is upon the mu'min and upon the believer to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for those ni'am. فَأَمَّا بِنِعْمَةِ رَبِّكَ فَحَدِّثْ, as Allah Azza wa Jalla mentioned, and as far as the ni'am and the blessings of your Lord, then proclaim those ni'am. Similarly, Ikhwan, we always like to mention the fact that that which we began this lecture with was the khutbah or the sermon known as the khutbatul haja. The khutbatul haja, or the sermon of need, was a sermon that was used and was recited by the Messenger of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and not only that, but he taught it to his companions just as he would teach them a surah from the Quran. And the Messenger of Allah would use that address, Ikhwan, when he would begin marriages, he would use it when he would begin in his sermons, his khutab, and he would use it, Ikhwan, in different arenas and in different circumstances. Now, as we mentioned, Ikhwan, the Messenger of Allah, he would utilize the khutbatul haja, or the sermon of need, whenever he would give. It would be a good idea to centralize this, Ikhwan, if there's any way we can move this to the middle. Can we move this to the middle? Is it on wheels?
Yeah, that's good. wheels?
No. Is it stock? So you usually have to have the electrics like this?
Yes.
Hello. So the Messenger of Allah, he would begin, Ikhwan, his sermons and his addresses with this khutbah or with this sermon of need. And that is that he would begin, Ikhwan, by saying, Inna alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruh, to the end of the sermon. And Ikhwan, there occurs a hadith, an authentic hadith in Sahih Muslim, wherein the Messenger of Allah, he utilized the khutbatul haja on an occasion for the guidance of an individual. And that is, Ikhwan, that when the Messenger of Allah began giving his da'wah, there was an individual that was known as Damad ibn Tha'labat al-Azdi. Damad ibn Tha'labat al-Azdi, Ikhwan, was from among those individuals who were known prior to Islam for curing people from the jinn. That if a person was affected, a person was afflicted, a person had with him a demon of some sort, or he had, Ikhwan, a jinn with him, an evil spirit, then no doubt Dhamad ibn Tha'labah was known to be from among those who would cure from that. And so when he passed by the Nadawat and he passed by the gatherings of the Arab, which in the beginnings, Ikhwan, and the Arab and the Mushrikun of Quraysh, they would have that which were known as the Nadawat, or the sittings wherein the Arab would gather and they would discuss the things that were taking place in that area, in the village, and in the surroundings. And that was known, they were known as the Nadwa, or the sittings of the Arab. And so when Dhamad ibn Tha'labah passed by those Nadawat, and he heard that which was being mentioned concerning the Messenger of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and the fact that he was a man that was possessed, that he was Majnoon, the fact that he was someone that was deranged, it occurred to him that seeing that Muhammad has a jinn and he is possessed, it occurred to him that therefore I should offer him my services and try and cure him. And so when he came across the Messenger of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam on an occasion, he said, Ya Muhammad, do you not see that I should cure you? Yani from this jinn and from this possession that I hear the mushrikun, I hear the people of Quraysh mentioning concerning you. And so when the Messenger of Allah heard that, he turned to Dhamad ibn Tha'labah and said, Inna alhamdulillah. نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. And so Dhamad ibn Tha'labah, when he heard that, he said, Ya Muhammad, verily I have heard the words of soothsayers, and I have heard the words of magicians, and I have heard the words of poets, but never have I heard the likes of that which you've just mentioned to me just now. Repeat it to me. And the Messenger mentioned that 3 times. And that indicates, brothers and sisters, the fact that the Khutbatul Haja, just those few lines and the meanings that are present within them, and that which is in them from wisdom and from ilm, is something very great. He said, never have I heard the likes of that statement. And I've heard the words of soothsayers, magicians, poets, and the likes. And so he mentioned them 3 times. And so he said, give me your hand and let me pledge allegiance to you, to al-Islam. And upon that, Dhamad ibn Tha'labah, he embraced Ikhwan al-Islam. And so, Ikhwan, this khutbatul haja, it is befitting that every single one of the brothers learns it, acquaints himself with it and with its meanings. And Ikhwan, from our scholars, there are those who have written books just explaining the khutbatul haja alone. And maybe, Ikhwan, we can make that a separate lecture on an occasion and work through perhaps the book of Sheikh al-Muhaddith Muhammad Nasiruddin al-Albani, who has written, Ikhwan, around the explanation of the khutbatul haja. As far as that which we have come to discuss, Ikhwan, that most important fundamental topic, and that of tawheed, and the fact that tawheed, Ikhwan, is the miftah, or the key to Jannah,